Aloha, I'm your Mina Van Dyken MD from Out of the Doldrums. Today, together with you, we're gonna make an amazing nitric oxide boosting, oral microbiome improving mouth rinse. I like to think of it as a mouth rinse instead of a mouthwash. Why, you might ask? Because it really is its own thing. It's not a mouthwash. It's not a nice, minty, refreshing mouthwash. Some of those mouthwashes have been shown to damage the healthy bacteria that live in the crypts and the crevices of our tongue, and as a result, become a threat to our overall health. For more details on this, check out the video we made on oral hygiene, the oral microbiome, and nitric oxide production. It's linked in the description below. So if you're looking for that minty, alcohol-filled, microbiome massacring mouthwash DIY recipe, this isn't the right place for you. But if you're here to learn how to make a DIY mouth rinse that is healthy for your oral microbiome and it boosts nitric oxide production, welcome. My hope with this video is to crowdsource an even better recipe with your help. This is my first iteration. I'm sure all of you will have ideas and suggestions on how to improve on it. While I do have a minor degree in biochemistry, I am no chemist. So chemists out there, please give me feedback. Let me know how to improve this recipe. Actually, really, no matter who you are, your opinion is important to me. So throw your suggestions and feedback in the comments below. Together, we can make the best and healthiest DIY mouth rinse recipe ever. All these ingredients have been hand-selected after very careful and thorough research, culminating in a crazy-looking but healthy solution. Also, some of these ingredients may sound exotic, but they can all be readily purchased online. To help you out, I've placed links in the description below to Amazon, where you can purchase some of these ingredients. The companies I recommend and the ones that I link make a good product. In full disclosure, if you click the link to buy the ingredient, Out of the Doldrums gets a tiny commission from Amazon, like pennies, but it helps us out. So if you choose to do that, we appreciate the support. Okay, let's briefly review the ingredients and why they made the cut. First, calcium carbonate. It's literally from limestone. Calcium carbonate has been shown to remineralize, meaning it can play a role in adding minerals back to the teeth and help build them back up. What's also nice is that calcium carbonate has gentle cleansing benefits, and it can help loosen the food particles in the mouth. Second ingredient, L-arginine. Such a great ingredient. L-arginine is a precursor to nitric oxide via a pathway called the nitric oxide synthase pathway. But that's not the only thing L-arginine is good at. It's also an agent that prevents tooth decay and remineralizes the teeth. On top of that, L-arginine works together with the calcium we added earlier to deposit a dentine-like material made of calcium and phosphate that forms a plug in a protective layer on the surface of the dentinal tubules. One study even demonstrated that daily treatment with an arginine and calcium mouthwash for 8 weeks reduced dentine sensitivity. So it could help with sensitive teeth. Third up, L-citrulline. This is another precursor to nitric oxide via the nitric oxide synthase pathway. Research has shown that L-citrulline has a higher nitric oxide yield than L-arginine, so it makes sense to add it to the recipe. Fourth ingredient, turmeric. Turmeric is anti-inflammatory, antibacterial, and anti-plaque. Fifth up, beetroot powder. Literally, powder from dried beets. It has those amazing nitrates that feed our oral bacteria and get converted into nitric oxide. Note that this nitric oxide is formed via a different pathway than the other ingredients like L-arginine and L-citrulline. This is formed by the nitrate-nitrite-nitric oxide pathway with the help of the good bacteria that live in the crypts of our tongue. For more information on the details of this, visit the other video I made on nitric oxide and oral hygiene choices. It's linked in the description below. I could talk about this pathway and beets and nitric oxide and the oral microbiome all day long. But we gotta move on. We've got a mouth rinse to make. Ingredient number 6, sodium bicarbonate, also known as baking soda. This is an important ingredient with a few different functions. First, it's pH buffering. It keeps our oral pH perfect. The oral pH is an important determinant of a healthy oral microbiome. Low salivary flow and low pH generally encourage the presence of pathogenic or bad bacteria, and it also encourages the presence of cariogenic bacteria or cavity-causing bacteria. So when the pH in the mouth is just right, the oral microbiome can flourish. In addition to this, another study demonstrated that a mouthwash of sodium bicarbonate and water only adjusted the pH so that enamel demineralization was prevented and remineralization of enamel was enhanced. Another study showed that individuals undergoing chemotherapy for leukemia using a sodium bicarbonate mouthwash lowered the susceptibility to mouth ulcers. Seventh ingredient up, xylitol. Xylitol is a sugar alcohol that's commonly used as a sweetener. Now, before you go cringing because I'm adding a non-sugar sweetener to the pot, hear me out. The research is really strong on xylitol and oral health. Xylitol has been shown to inhibit the growth of harmful bacteria and prevents caries or cavities. It also has a significant anti-plaque effect on teeth surface and can reduce the gingival inflammation. And it's not only that, xylitol can bind to calcium, which results in remineralization of teeth enamel. If you want to learn more about xylitol, check out the references listed in the description below. There's a really nice paper in there reviewing its health benefits. Eighth ingredient, zinc citrate. Zinc is an essential trace element. It's necessary for the activity of over 300 enzymes in the human body. Despite the importance of zinc, the World Health Organization estimates that 31% of people worldwide are deficient in zinc. And this number goes up the more we age because we can't absorb it as readily. Zinc compounds have a variety of positive effects on oral health. They have antibacterial properties and they're used as an anti-plaque agent. Zinc ions also promote remineralization and prevent demineralization, so they reduce enamel solubility. In a nutshell, zinc protects our teeth, enamel, and dentin. And if this isn't enough, some studies also show that zinc can prevent halitosis, also known as bad breath. It does this by reducing sulfide compounds in the breath. You know, sulfur equals stinky, so get rid of the sulfur, get less stinky. Back to the zinc deficiency problem. When it comes to oral health, zinc deficiency has been associated with high rates of caries or cavities, as well as common oral mucosal diseases like lichen planus, burning mouth syndrome, xerostomia, and recurrent aphthous ulcers or ulcers in the mouth. To this end, zinc supplementation may be useful in the prevention and treatment of these conditions. Awesome. Bring on the zinc. Ninth ingredient, cloves. Small amount. Cloves contain eugenol, which is a gentle antimicrobial. And to be honest, I added them because they make the mouth rinse a little more palatable. If you wanted, you could skip the cloves and add a few drops of peppermint oil to the wash right before you swish, whatever flavor profile you prefer. I prefer the clove. Okay, last ingredient, filtered water. It is so important to use filtered water so there's no fluoride or other tap water chemicals in there that could interfere with our mouthwash ingredients. Okay, let's throw all this together. We got our handy dandy jar. We go with 2 tablespoons calcium carbonate, 2 tablespoons L-arginine, 2 tablespoons L-citrulline, 2 teaspoons turmeric, 2 tablespoons beetroot powder, look at that, so pretty. 3 tablespoons baking soda. 3 tablespoons xylitol. We've got our zinc citrate. Ooh, this will be a fun pour. There we go. And we got our ground cloves. Okay, so you've got your awesome little mix here. Stick a lid on it. You want a big jar so you have room to shake. And then you shake. Shake it like you mean it. Get it all mixed up till you have a really nice pinkish powder and it's all uniform. Then voila, you have your mouth rinse mix. I'm going to put a fun little label on it. Nitric oxide mouth rinse. Yep. So we're going to put that on. You don't have to do this part. I just like to be nerdy. Okay. Nitric oxide mouth rinse. Okay, so you've got your mouth rinse mix. When you're ready to use it, all you do is you've got your small jar. You've got 50 ml of filtered water in here. It's about 1/4 cup filtered water. You're gonna add 1 teaspoon to your mix. Just 1 teaspoon, not much. at it. Then you're going to shake it up. Yep. Then you're going to sip it and swish for as long as you possibly can. Bathe those healthy bacteria that live in the deep crypts of your tongue. Get your teeth in your inner cheeks. When you can swish no longer, then you can spit it out. While all of this is food grade and it wouldn't be harmful if it was swallowed, I wouldn't advise swallowing it. Feel free to do this mouth rinse at least 3 times daily. You may feel a slight tingle in your gums and mucous membranes as a result of this. That's normal, and it's a good sign. More blood flow to the area. All right, it's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this DIY video on how to make my oral microbiome improving, nitrate and nitric oxide producing, teeth enamel and dentin protecting, and remineralizing mouthwash. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to show us some real support, subscribe. This is a work in progress, so let me know how you liked it. Did you source all your ingredients okay? How do you think it tasted? How would you improve on this recipe? Let's crowdsource an even better formulation. How about this question? Did you notice a difference after using it? I know I did. I got a new PR, or personal record, on my Peloton bike that I'd been chasing for months after using the mouth rinse for 1 day. Placebo effect, mouth rinse, who knows, but I smashed my PR. Anyways, all right, stay safe, stay healthy, and aloha. Want to gurgle?
Now that stuff tastes bad. Zoom!
What you gotta do is add a teaspoon to a small jar. I need a teaspoon. Want to toss me one? Whoop! Okay, so you're gonna add a teaspoon to a small jar. I have a cute, where's my cute little jar? Hang on. This is a disaster.